Hello everyone, welcome to the Engineering Projects YouTube channel. In this video tutorial, I will guide you about how you can create an XML file in C#. XML is a platform independent language so that the information formatted in XML can be used in any other platform or operating system. Once we create an XML file in one platform, it can be used in other platform also. In order to creating a new XML file in C#, we are using XML text writer class. The class take file name and encoding argument. Also, we are here passing formatting details. Now in the following video I will create XML file product XML and add 4 rows in the file. So I will first of all add a button here. Now activate its event handler by double clicking on it, or you can go to here and event handler is added here. Now I will say that I will want to create the writer of XML. I will say XML text XML text writer and add its library, okay, and name it is as writer is equal new XML text writer, and in parentheses I will name it as product.xml, the name of the file which I want to create, and next to it after comma I will use the encoding system system.txt.encoding.utf 8, which is the standard right now for writing XML code. Now I will, next to this line I will say writer dot write statement write start document write start document write start document make it true so the application know that from here we are starting our XML code. Writer dot formatting, and formatting is equal dot intended, so in every line there is an intent, and writer dot indentation will be 2, it's mean up to 2 level intent will be show, and writer dot write start element start element will be the table, and let's create the node. Create, simply write create node in parentheses, you have to add the library create node, and I have create the node function here, and I want to pass some variables in this node. So what I will do, I will write first I will write the create node code so that it will be easy to understand what I am going to do. So first parameter will be string product, it will be product ID comma, then string name, then string price, and then I will say that here XML text writer and pass a writer object here. And when I will pass the writer object here, I will say that it will get from writer dot write start element from product. So the first element of node is product, then again after product there is product underscore ID, and then I will write dot write string, so the child will be product ID, and then the writer dot write and we have to search here and element. Here is the and element. Now this code is one node of product. Now I am going to create another node of product, copy and paste and name it as product name, and simply change it PID to simply name, and again paste this code, and now change it is into price and copy this code here and pass the price and again and the element. Now this statement show that the product is ending here. Okay, now let's move on to the node. Now first parameter will be the ID, so ID is 1 comma, the next parameter is the name of the product. I will say Apple is a product comma, the third is the price, so price is 100 comma, and then pass the writer object writer. Okay, so it will create a node. So let's create 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, and 4, and change name this mango, something like okay, this is we have done it. Now I will say and the element here, so I will copy the paste here and the element here, and then and the document and the document here, then writer dot close and it's close, and show the message box dot show file is created. So the file will get created with the name of product XML. Now execute the code, and when I will click this button it say file is created. I don't know where this file is created. Let's go to documents, Visual Studio, my project, TAP, and I don't know where the file is created. So here is the product XML. I will open it with Sublime Text, and here you can observe that I have a lot of code here. So I will say open with Notepad. So here you will get that the product ID is 1, product name is Apple, product price is 100, product ID is equal to mango 1030 and so on, the table XML is created. I hope this video tutorial is informative for you. If you still have any kind of question, you can ask us, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel. Take care. Bye bye.